Hello students, welcome back to science class. In the last class, we were discussed the water is precious. Each drop of water is precious. As we know that, the 2/3 of the earth is surrounded by water, right? But the amount of potable water, it is very, very less. Okay, in the previous class, we were discussed an activity. In that activity, you will come to know that the process evaporation. So children, what is evaporation? Suppose I have a salt solution with me. So if I am keeping the salt solution nearby the sunlight, what happens? After some times, all the water molecules will be escaped in the form of vapor. And the salt will be left at my hand. Right? This process is called evaporation. Okay. If the same process, if it happens in seawater, children, you know, the seawater is saline water, right? So it is not suitable for drinking and for other domestic purposes. So we have to desalinate the water and we are using it, right? But the sea, the river, the ocean, these all are the factors of rain, right? So imagine that from the sea level, from the sea water, the whole water molecules will be evaporates. From the river, water molecules evaporates. From the ocean, it evaporates. From ponds, all the natural water reservoirs, from everywhere, the water molecules evaporates. So what happens? As it moves higher, what happens? The temperature decreases. So that time, when it reaches to the above atmospheric level, what happens? This starts to condense it. Okay, so by the time it condenses, what happens? The water molecules will be slowly and gradually come closer, and finally it comes closer with dust particles, and finally it forms clouds. So these clouds will be capable to hold all the moisture content. By the time the moisture content exceeds, what happens? This clouds start to precipitate. The precipitate in the form of rain, and it will be precipitate in the form of snowfalls or in the form of hails. These are the types of precipitation. Okay, you can see the interesting activities of evaporation. So evaporation can be taken place everywhere. Suppose if I am keeping all the clothes in a line, what happens? After some times, it will be easily dried up. Right? Or if I am keeping, you have an activity in your textbook. In a 2 bowl, you have to take water. The one bowl you have to keep near the sunlight, and the other bowl you have to keep in the shady areas. So which will be undergo evaporation faster? The bowl which you kept in the sunlight will be undergo evaporation fast. Okay, everywhere evaporation takes place. Evaporation is one factor for the precipitation, and one more factor is there. You have learned in the previous chapter the process called transpiration. What is transpiration? Transpiration is nothing but the process of loss of water molecules from the leaves. So this evaporation and transpiration, lot of water molecules are reaches to the atmosphere. And from the atmosphere, it condenses. After condensation, it reaches as a water in the form, precipitation of taking place. So this is called water cycle. This is called water cycle. So this is happens throughout the world. Students, you know one interesting factor. All the rivers are reaches to the Bay of Bengal, right? The Indian Bay of Bengal. So from there, it gradually and slowly merges with Pacific Ocean. Okay, from the Pacific Ocean, it reaches to the American continent. From American continent, what happens? Again, there is a cloud formation. From there again, it will be fall as a rain. From there, it again reaches to the different parts of the river in America. From there, it reaches to the Atlantic Ocean. From the Atlantic Ocean, it slowly and gradually merges with the areas of the Europe. Okay, in such a way, the water gets recycled. Okay, this is also the one of the interesting factor. You can see when all the rivers, all the oceans, they are all merged with those water. So it is a cyclic process. Okay,